Good morning, all of you. In today's discussion, we are going to discuss the suturing materials and techniques, a very long topic and a very basic one in surgical sciences and in the management of patients in triage and emergency. So we'll finish it up in few parts. So today's discussion will be regarding the sutures, and we are going to cover it in the part one video. Now, what is an ideal suture? These are the important the characteristics. The knot should be easily placed, easy to tie or secure. Knot should be there after using any suture material. The first advantage. The second, the characteristic could be there should be very little tissue reaction. It should not be allergenic. And for long period, the suture should maintain its tensile strength to hold the tissue while the healing is taking place. So three important things in this slide: easy to tie, less tissue reaction, longer tensile strength holding time. The suture material can be broadly classified into the natural one and the synthetic suture material. The examples of natural suture material is like silk or catgut. Catgut is an example of absorbable natural suture material, and silk is an example of synthetic suture material. Silk is an example of non-absorbable natural suture material. Now, nowadays in the emergency, most of the suture material, they are usually synthetic. The suture material we are using nowadays, the synthetic one, most commonly used. And they can be divided into two types: the polyfilament or braided suture material and monofilament or non-braided suture material. And again, in these two categories, in the synthetic one, we are having two groups: the non-absorbable and absorbable. And based on the memory of the suture and tensile strength of the suture, the properties, they may vary. And let's see how the memory is going to affect. The memory of the suture material means the suture tries to stay in its original shape. If you remember the Newton's law of inertia, it tries to stay in its original shape, doesn't want to change its shape. So suture tries to stay in its original shape. This is known as memory of the suture. Memory can lead to a difficulty while placing a knot. A sort of a problem while placing a knot, and this problem is more with monofilament sutures. The amount of force, the tensile strength, it is the amount of force required to break a suture. And this tensile strength, along with time, it diminishes. The suture will become weaker depending on the type of suture material we are using. This tensile strength, time, this vary according to the suture material. And the meaning of tensile strength is how much amount of force we require to break a suture. So ideally speaking, memory should be less and tensile strength should be adequate according to the use of the suture material, right? And tensile strength is usually measured as how long it takes for the suture material to have half its original strength. Half its original strength lost in how many days? This is tensile strength, the unit. For example, 50% tensile strength of polydioxone, commonly known as PDS, is 28 days. Polygalactin, commonly known as Vicryl, is 18 days. So these two suture material, they are suitable for placing or for closure where we need the suture approximation more than, let's say, 10 days or 2 weeks in few cases. So polydioxone 28 days, polygalactin 18 days. In 28 days, polydioxone or PDS loses its 50% of tensile strength. And in 18 days, Vicryl loses its 50% tensile strength. Only 50% remains. Now, there are some advantages of braided sutures or polyfilamentous sutures having many filaments braided together. For example, in natural sutures, silk is one of the example of braided or polyfilamentous suture material. And in synthetic one, there are many examples braided suture material, and usually they are available as braided as well as non-braided also, synthetic one, right? The tying knots, the secure knots are easy to tie with braided sutures. And these braided suture material or polyfilamentous suture material, they have less memory. And that was our requirement for an ideal suture. Less memory as compared to monofilament. And the important thing is, as there are many filaments braided together, there is less risk of suture fracture when we are handling the suture with a forceps. So less chance of suture fracture in braided suture material. These are the advantages of braided sutures. On the other hand, the non-braided or monofilament sutures having a single filament, they have advantages of less tissue reaction. Less tissue reaction by the body. And second important advantage of monofilament is less incidence of infection, or there is less chance of micro abscess formation in the tissue on the site of placement. Now, advantages of absorbable sutures. Absorbable suture material, they need not to be removed. Once placed, it usually gets dissolved or removed by itself. And these absorbable suture material indication, wherever you are placing the sutures over the mucosal area, mucosal surface, you can use the absorbable suture material. Over the skin, it's always better to place a non-absorbable suture material. So, absorbable sutures not being required to be removed, and they are not present after the wound healing has been achieved. These are the advantages of absorbable suture material. For skin closure, we can use a subcuticular absorbable sutures. Whenever we are using any suture material below the skin, it's always preferable to use absorbable suture material. Whenever we are using any suture material over the skin, we can use interrupted monofilament non-absorbable suture material. It's always better to use non-absorbable over the skin, absorbable subcuticular under the skin. Right? Advantage we have already discussed, the advantage of using monofilament sutures or non-braided suture. See, in some indications, if we are placing a continuous suture, we always prefer a monofilament suture if available. Why? Because the monofilament suture, it slides through the tissue very easily. It slides easily, as well as it reduces the chances of tissue bunching. Right? Easily slide, less tissue bunching with monofilament sutures while placing a continuous suture. In sites where wound healing takes longer, it is advisable to use a suture with longer 50% tensile strength and absorption rate. For example, whenever we are using an abdominal wound during an exploratory laparotomy, we are going to use polydiaxone for linear alba closure. Right? Polydiaxone for linear alba closure in exploratory laparotomy. What is the size? What should be the ideal size of suture material or diameter of suture material? And the sutures were sized using the United States Pharmacopoeia, and few of the example is like this. You can see here the suture number, commonly known as like this. You can call it like 60 or 60. Whatever you like, you can use any one of it method. 60 is equivalent to diameter of the suture material in millimeters. 0.07 millimeter, less than a millimeter is 60. So 80 or 60, these are commonly used in ophthalmics, especially the 80 ophthalmic surgery, right? The cornea surgery, ocular surgery. 60 to 40 commonly used, sometimes even 30 also commonly used in cosmetic surgery or plastic surgery. You can see the diameter of 40 0.15 30 0.2 millimeters, again less than a millimeter, all are less than a millimeter. You can see half a millimeter is number 2. So these are the examples of suture number and the equivalent diameter of the suture material in millimeters. So just remember, number 2 is half a millimeter size and number 20 is 0.3 millimeter. Right? 20 is commonly used in surgery. And again, it is related to the diameter of the thread. As we can divide, we have discussed the monofilament or non-braided suture material. Here it is braided. Both are having non-absorbable and absorbable groups. Example of non-absorbable monofilament is polyamide suture or nylon suture. It is non-absorbable, synthetic. Then absorbable monofilament, polydaxon, PDS, polyglyconate, Maxon, monofilament. Now braided means having many filaments, the polyfilament. The non-absorbable example is braided nylon. Here it was nylon, it is braided nylon, known as neurilon. And this is absorbable braided. This is polyglactin, commonly known as Vicryl, very commonly used in our hospital. Then polyglycolic acid, Dexon. Here this Vicryl is also available as monofilament in our country. Okay, in the name of Monocryl. Then just an example of the type of suture material with its 50% tensile strength. How many days it takes, after how many days it only has 50% tensile strength, and absorption time. So let's start with coated polyglactin, also known as Vicryl Rapid. This is having a 50% tensile strength as 6 days, very rapidly absorbed. The synthetic non-braided example, Vicryl Rapid. The term rapid is there, 6 days. So what does it mean? It means whenever we are using, suppose let's say a case of exploratory laparotomy, abdomen we have opened up, now we have done our work and we want to close the linear alveolar, the midline incision. In that case, this Vicryl Rapid should not be used. Why? Because it is having the absorption time around 10 days, as well as the 50% tensile strength is lost just after 6 days. And we want at least that suture material approximation at least for more than 10 days or better 2 weeks. Right? So this Vicryl Rapid don't use in closing the linear alveolar in laparotomies. This is a take home message for this information. The second example is polyglycolic acid, Dexon. 50% tensile strength, 16 days. Good for exploratory wound closure also, the laparotomy closures. The absorption time is 60 to 90 days. So better it can be utilized if the patient is malnourished, nutritional deficiencies are there, nutrition wise not okay, but yes, due to some perforation or some abdominal emergencies, we have operated that patient. If it is available, better to use polyglycolic acid. Polyglactin Vicryl, 18 days 50% tensile strength, 28 days absorption time. Good, we can use it for laparotomies. Then polydaxon PDS. Out of these four, the best choice is polydaxon PDS. Use PDS for closing an abdominal wound. 28 days, 50% tensile strength, and 180 days absorption time. So it's always better to use PDS if available. If not, you can use Vicryl or Dexon, whatever is available, but don't use Vicryl Rapid in emergency laparotomies. Right? Although the various types of suture material we have discussed, they usually belong to the synthetic group. A few points regarding the natural one. The silk is available in our country, usually as braided suture material. Very easy to place knots with silk. Catgut is available in our country. So these two can also be used if these synthetic material sutures are not available. Right? And that's all for today. And we'll continue this discussion the next subsequent part. Any question, any query, you can write in the comment section. I'll go through those comments and we'll try to discuss. Thank you. Thank you so much.